beheaded Alan Henning, a British hostage. I just want to read what we have here. President Obama condemning this, what he calls a brutal murder, and part of the statement reads, "Standing together with our UK friends and allies, we will work to bring the perpetrators of Alan's murder, as well as the murders of Jim Foley, Stephen Sotloff, and David Haynes, to justice. Standing together with a broad coalition of allies and partners, we will continue taking decisive action to degrade and ultimately to destroy ISIL." And I want to bring in now CNN's Brian Todd. You were working on this story, and really, at this point, the president here condemning this murder, but you also have a process where administration officials are trying to verify exactly that this video is authentic.
That's right. And they say right now there's no reason to doubt that it is authentic, Brianna, but they are examining it very closely on both sides of the Atlantic because each of these videos gives them more possible clues into the location and other pieces of information about ISIS that are so crucial. As Brianna mentioned, U.S. and British officials responding with outrage tonight over this video. British Prime Minister David Cameron saying just a short time ago that Alan Henning's murder, quote, shows just how barbaric and repulsive these terrorists are, end quote. Lisa Monaco, Assistant to President Obama for Homeland Security, says this is just another example of ISIS brutality. The video, to recap, released by ISIS just a short time ago, showing the apparent beheading of British aid worker Alan Henning. In the same video, the terror group threatens the life of American aid worker Peter Kasich. Kasich was captured a year ago on October 1st on his way to eastern Syria. A U.S. intelligence official tells CNN tonight that U.S. intelligence is very aware of this videotape, looking into it, examining it for clues, as it has with the other ISIS videotaped execution videos. This U.S. official says there is no reason to doubt tonight to believe that this videotape is not authentic. The official had no comment on the threat to Peter Kasich. To recap on Alan Henning, he is a taxi driver from near Manchester, England. He was part of a team of volunteers that traveled to Syria in December 2013 to deliver food, water, ambulances, and other supplies to people affected by the civil war there. He was abducted the day after Christmas by masked gunmen. That was according to other people in his aid convoy. Last week, the British Foreign Office released an audio file of Henning pleading for his life. His wife also made a public plea for ISIS to spare his life. Her appeals also joined by voices of Muslim leaders around the world, and even some jihadist groups had weighed in, appealing to ISIS to release him. And if the authenticity is confirmed, as we suspect it will be, Henning is going to be the fourth Westerner to be beheaded on camera by ISIS. This summer, ISIS beheaded American journalists James Foley and Stephen Sotloff, gruesomely showing their killings in videos posted online. The group then claimed its first British victim, aid worker David Haynes. That was according to a video that appeared online on September 13th. Alan Henning appeared kneeling in that latest video with an ISIS militant standing by his side. Brianna, these families are all in agony tonight. You've got to be feeling for the family of Peter Kasich tonight, given the sequence of events.
Yeah, we certainly are. Brian Todd, thank you for your report.